Good afternoon. Welcome to Halftime Report. It's 12 noon. We're halfway through the training session and in the midst of a roaring bull run as we speak. So still higher by close to about 1-odd%. Keep your eye firmly on the Nifty Bank. We're currently just about 80, 85 points away from hitting a lifetime high on the Bank Nifty. As we speak, across the key indices, higher by close to about 1%. The only thing that's happened in the last 1 hour or so is that the mid-cap index has come off from its earlier gains. So while the Nifty and the Bank Nifty has largely been on the flatter side, you can see the dip coming through in the mid-cap index. Earlier, it was up 1%. Now, as we speak, up 0.5%. Hi, Lata.
Oh, hi. Actually, you summed it up nicely. It's just that the roaring bull market in Asia should not be lost sight of. We are hardly the best performing market if you picked up Hang Seng, Nikkei, Kospi, Taiwan. Look at those indices. Nikkei up almost 2%, Hang Seng over 1%. So we mustn't run away that this is an India-specific rally. It's quite clearly a tidal wave that's lifting all boats. And as you correctly pointed out, important to note that when FIIs make such a grand entry, they usually chase big caps. And so those who were so far punting on the mid-cap stocks, largely HNIs, are now probably shifting gears, taking away some money from mid-caps and following the leader, which at the moment happens to be FIIs. We'll, of course, thrash out all this and more in the next 1 hour as we take you through Halftime Report. It's a day when there are a lot of stocks that are buzzing, and so very interesting movers and shakers ahead for you with our entire research team. Let me start with Reema. What are you watching out for? Bharti Twins.
Absolutely. So Bharti Airtel is higher in trade. On the flip side, Bharti Infratel is under pressure. The news is that Bharti Airtel will be transferring a 32% stake in Bharti Infratel to its subsidiary, Netel Infra. It should be around a price of 290 rupees per share, which is the 60-day volume-weighted price of Bharti Infratel. Now, that appears to be a steep discount where the stock is currently quoting at. But bear in mind, Bharti Infratel has seen a strong rally in 2019 with a rally of 22%. Now, this, as of now, will be an intercompany transfer, which will take place either on 18th or after 18th of March. There will be no change in the debt profile of the Bharti Airtel group. This is an intercompany transfer. But the reason why Bharti Airtel is excited in trade is because this is seen as the first step to the first step for the company monetizing its Infratel stake eventually. So what the company will do is now they will transfer their Infratel stake to the wholly owned subsidiary, Netel Infra, and Netel Infra later, once the Indus merger is completed, they will sell it to an external party. And once that happens, Bharti Airtel's monetization in Infratel will take place and Bharti Airtel group comes down. So that's the key thing. For now, it's just a step closer to the company eventually monetizing its Infratel stake. But that can happen only after the Indus merger is through. And with that, Bharti Airtel stake will fall from 50.3 to 18.3%.
Okay, got that, which explains why Bharti Infratel is down and Bharti Airtel is up. Let's get to the other stock. Among the stocks that are buzzing today in the pharma space is Aurobindo Pharma. Ekta here to tell us why.
Yes, well, I am picking up from my sources that Aurobindo is Unit 4 has received an EIR or an establishment inspection report from the US FDA. Now, what an EIR basically means is that the inspection is closed and most likely the company will start getting approvals from that particular facility. Why is this important? Is because Unit 4 is actually one of Aurobindo's most important plants. It's their only injectable plant where they manufacture injectable products. They have a strong guidance of around 25-30% growth in terms of the injectable segment, and that was based on the fact that they will get approvals from this particular facility. But in December of 2018, it was inspected by the US FDA. It had received two observations, and those two observations were quite concerning for the markets. Now, having received an EIR, the market seems to be a little more, less concerned about this particular facility, considering that approval should start picking up now.
Okay. Well, that's good news with the drug authority deciding on the side of Aurobindo Pharma. With that, let's shift focus to HDFC Life. There is a big block deal over there with Standard Life moving out, Abhishek.
Well, Standard Life is offering, you know, about 10 crore shares with a base option of 7 crore shares and a green shoe option of 2.95 crore shares. So the base price that they have set for this deal is about 357.5, which is at a discount of more than 8% to yesterday's closing price. So the overall stake in SDFC Life of Standard Life will actually reduce by 5% to near to about 24%. Through this stake sale, you know, Standard Life will get about 3,560 odd crores in terms of the amount received from the stake sale. Back to you.
Thank you very much for that. And let's focus now on the real estate sector. Names like Indiabulls Real Estate is higher by 7%. Nitesh Estates is also rising in trade. Sonal Bhutra joins us for more on that. Sonal, after being hit hard on account of demonetization, GST, RERA, we've seen a huge slowdown in real estate companies. But now there appears to be a silver lining with a pickup seen at the ground level for these real estate companies.
Absolutely, Reema. That is what the reports are suggesting. In fact, there is a very interesting report by CLSA today where they say that the gross fixed capital formation, that is a key measure of the investment activities in an economy, that fell down to 28% in FY17 versus the levels of 34% that we saw in FY. They also say that around 60% of this decline was led by the housing sector. And if we want to see any broad-based recovery, capex recovery, it has to come from the housing sector. They also said that the NBFC slowdown led to the delay in the housing market demand rise, and now they are seeing that there are chances of improvement. So by end of calendar year 19, they're expecting some improvement in the real estate sector, and that will be driven by affordability that the consumers will be facing. So now they are saying that GFCF, that is the gross fixed capital formation, has bottomed out, and they are seeing an uptick of around 90 basis points from the June 17 lows that this particular level saw. They are saying that post-demonetization, the new housing sales, they are up around 30 to 40% on a YOY basis in 2018. And that is something that we could see in the books of the listed players as well. They did very well as far as the new sales and bookings were concerned. They are also saying that the affordable housing program is doing well, and they have, the houses sold under affordable housing has almost doubled to around 4.1 million in 2018 itself. And the recent measures that were taken by the government, the GST rate cut, that will actually boost consumer sentiment. It'll also lead to more sales of the slow-moving inventory that is unsold, and also certain measures that were taken in budget with respect to capital gains. All this will lead to boost in consumer sentiment. In this particular sector, their top picks are Godrej Properties, Sobha, HDFC, Astral Poly, and also Supreme Industries. All these plays are something that they like. Back to you.
Thank you, Sonal, for that. A quick recap then of the top buzzing stocks at noon. We've got Bharti Infra, Aurobindo Pharma, HDFC Life, Godrej Properties, Sobha Developers, HDFC Limited, Astral Supreme, finally, Ramco as well. News coming in on Mahindra CIE, where the board has approved the acquisition of Aurangabad Electricals. Try and get more details on that. But Lata, we've got a management waiting by.
Yes, MEP Infra is the stock on our radar. After the company secured over 1,400 crores for three hybrid annuity road projects. To discuss this and more, Jayant Maiskar, Chairman Managing Director of the company, joins us on the phone line. Mr. Maiskar, good morning. Is this the first time you will be constructing on an annuity or a HAM basis? Until now, you were more the toll collector, right?
Good afternoon. I think we need to look back a couple of years back, since when MEP has actually started in the development of roads. The company currently is doing 10 hybrid annuity projects, 6 of them.
Mr. Maiskar? Okay, we'll do one thing. We'll take a break. We need to reconnect on that phone and check out what are the latest three hybrid annuity projects that they have got orders for and how they will change the P&L of the company.
Actually, this Mahindra CIE acquisition is fairly significant. The company will be paying 830 crore rupees for this acquisition. The revenues of the acquired company, that's Aurangabad Electrical, stand at 651 crore. The profits are at 34.5 crore.
And the debt?
And they have a debt of about 88 crores, thereabout. But the reason for the acquisition, the company said, it will ensure the company's entry into the automotive aluminium die casting segment. It diversifies their subscriber base and also seen value accretive. So the size is quite significant. 830 crores is the payout.
The market's giving it a thumbs up at this point in time. 830 crore for a 600 crore revenue company, but only 34 crore
by the management profit. Says it's value accretive.
Okay, so that is an important acquisition for Mahindra. So we'll try and get you more details from the company.